Please use your personal protective equipment as directed by your tutor or as indicated by your worksheet. Using a top hand balance, ensure the balance is turned on at the mains, then press on, which is also the zero button. Wait for the counter to arrive on screen and wait for the counter to reach zero. If the balance is already zeroed, leave it as is. If it doesn't read zero, press the zeroing button. Using your previously prepared sample, make sure it is dated and labelled correctly. Use a weighing vessel to weigh out your sample. Place the weighing vessel on the balance and zero the balance. Then, using the spatula, weigh out precisely 2 grams of your sample into the weighing vessel. Take the accurately weighed 2 grams of copper sulfate, place into a beaker, then add distilled water. Stir the solution with a stirring rod to make sure that all the solid has dissolved. Wash out the weighing vessel with distilled water to ensure that no trace of the sample is left in the weighing vessel. Using a volumetric flask, make the sample up to precisely 100 millilitres. Use a funnel to transfer from the beaker to the volumetric flask. To ensure that all the sample solution is transferred to the volumetric flask, wash out the 100 milliliter beaker with distilled water. To ensure that the sample is precisely 100 millilitres, use a pipette to add the final drops of distilled water dropwise into the volumetric flask. Tilt the volumetric flask to ensure an even distribution of the solution. Then label the volumetric flask using a marker pen. Use the title of the solution and its concentration as your label. As part of good general lab practice, label all beakers and vessels used accurately. Decant the sample of copper sulfate into a beaker, so it can be easily poured into a burette. Repeat this process with distilled water. Please ensure that the burette has already been conditioned with distilled water. Then add the distilled water to perform your colorimetry. Note the initial volume of distilled water in the burette. Into the test tube labelled 1, add 9 millilitres of distilled water. Note the remaining volume in the burette before continuing. Repeat the process of adding distilled water to the tube labelled 2. This tube requires 8 millilitres of distilled water. Note the end volume in the burette. Repeat this step with tube number 3, adding only 7 millilitres of water to this tube. Repeat this process with decreasing volumes of distilled water for tubes 4 to 9. Ensure that the burette tap is closed before adding copper sulfate. The burette must be conditioned by using copper sulfate from your sample to rinse through the burette. Open the burette tap and release some of the copper sulfate into a beaker to ensure that there are no air bubbles in the burette tap. Note the initial reading of the volume of copper sulfate in the burette. Then release 1 milliliter of copper sulfate into the tube labelled number 1. Then note down the value of the volume left in the burette. Repeat this step for tube number 2, releasing 2 milliliters into this tube. Note the volume of copper sulfate remaining in the burette. Repeat this step with tube number 3, adding 3 millilitres of copper sulfate to this tube, and continue through tubes 4 to 9, adding increasing volumes of copper sulfate to each tube. At the end of the serial dilution process, the test tubes should contain solutions looking similar to this. Using the colorimeter, open up the SensorLab program by double-clicking on the icon on the desktop. Then proceed to the drop-down bar and the third item on this menu, which is smoothing colorimeter. Calibrating a colorimeter. For this experiment, use the red spectrum. This is a cuvette. To calibrate the colorimeter, fill the cuvette with distilled water. Place into the colorimeter and place on the cap. Then calibrate the colorimeter until a value of 100 is seen on the screen. When the colorimeter has been calibrated, remove the sample of distilled water. Then, using a pipette, fill a cuvette from the sample tube labeled number 9. There is no need to recalibrate the colorimeter to introduce this sample, as the calorimeter has already been calibrated for clear distilled water. Place in the sample from tube number 9 and note the value on the colorimeter on the computer screen. In the lab, there will be provided copper sulfate solutions at 2%, an A sample of copper sulfate and a B sample of copper sulfate, which are unknowns. Place the standard solution of 2% copper sulfate into a cuvette. Then place the cuvette into the colorimeter and top with the cap. Notice the value on screen for the known solution. Repeat the process using sample A and sample B to determine their values. As part of good lab practice, equipment used during an experiment should be cleaned and tidily stored away. This is part of your assessment. To remove any marker pen indications on equipment, use a few drops of ethanol on a clean paper towel.